to Scott Lee.
This is the infamous wall that every pupil aspires to be on. I know I sat here many a time looking up at all the famous people thinking, I want to be on that wall.
All that and lots of lovely wedding photographs as well after this short. The computer picked finalists at random and they're in this hat and I am going to ask Lisa to pick the winner. See who we've got.
Do you want me to read
it? Yeah, please.
Okay. Derek Barnes from Norfolk.
Derek, what that means is that you are in the final on Friday, so you have got a chance to win that £150,000 Spanish villa, but also you get £1,000 anyway. So you've won £1,000 anyway, which is fantastic.
Well done, Derek.
Yes, exactly. Yes. Well done. Made his morning. Now, all this week, we are sending some of the UK's favourite faces back to school. Now, Lisa learnt her trade at one of the UK's top stage schools. That's the Italia Conti. And here's what happened when she went back for a visit.
Hi, everybody. I've come back here to my stage school, Italia Conti. I came here 8 years ago, and I've not been back since. And over the road is where I used to live. So have a look at the glamorous YMCA. Let's see how it's changed. Come on. Oh, it hasn't changed at all. And this is the infamous wall that every pupil aspires to be on. I know I sat here many a time looking up at all the famous people thinking, I want to be on that wall. And actually, these lovely girlies here were the year above me, Martine McCutcheon and lovely Louise. I grew up in Wales and I was a big fan of Fame and I think that probably started me off. I always wanted to come to stage school, you know, I loved singing and dancing and acting, everything. But this is really strange because I didn't know these pictures were here and these are three of my really good friends still. So we've got Jane, Tori and Lisa and we all went for lunch recently and we were giggling about all our old memories. And that reminds me, we were never allowed to use the lift. Pupils always have to use the stairs. 8 flights of them. Well, this is my old ballet studio. And ballet was one of my favourite classes. And Pat Prime took the class. And we used to do it at 8 o'clock on a Monday morning. So I had to be careful not to have too much of a late night on the Sunday. We also used this room to rehearse in for all the big productions and plays that we used to do. And looking back, you know, it stood me in good stead for all the shows that I did with Steps, you know, at Wembley and everywhere. Well, it's strange being back in this room, facing the mirrors, which we'd have to do in order to learn dance moves. Never thought that, you know, I'd go on to do more dance steps in such a big group like Steps. I've been playing the piano since I was a little girl, but when I started writing music, I got more into it and started to play my own songs. Why you left me? I recognise that music. Sounds like my old singing teacher. Hello.
How are you?
I'm very good. How are you?
Where's the time gone?
I know.
When I first heard Lisa's voice, you can sense it had a slight edge or uniqueness that you can sense, or however small it is.
I've thoroughly enjoyed my singing lessons and you know, it's really helped me obviously in the profession I've gone into. After I did my teacher's exams here, I left Conti's, went out into the big wide world. I saw an audition that was looking for energetic young singer dancers for a new boy-girl pop group. I went along to the audition. Got into Steps and the rest is history. If I gave any advice to the pupils that are currently at Italia Conti, I'd remind them that 8 years ago I was one of them and I think if you work really hard and you know you follow your dreams, you can do it.
Oh, that was really good. Lisa's here now. It's really good to see you.
Thank you.
Really good to see you. And that was a real trip down memory lane
for you, wasn't it? Really, I haven't been back, you know, since I graduated. So yeah, it was really lovely to go back.
Yeah, it was good stuff. Good stuff. And great memories with
the tragedy. I know, we're just having a good old chinwag,
weren't we? Oh, fantastic stuff.
Yeah,
really,
brilliant.
Really good stuff.
And absolutely love Steps. And hi to all the guys. Yeah, yeah. Really good.
Good fun. Good days, that's for sure. Now, you have had a fantastic year. Been absolutely brilliant.
Yeah.
You're now a happily married woman.
I am.
Tell me about the wedding. What was it like?
Oh, it was wonderful. I've been planning it for about a year and a half.
Wow.
And had some help of my friend Michelle and my parents and stuff like that. It was a lovely experience, you know, going to get the dress and everything. And it went really, really well, I'm glad to say. There weren't any hitches, so we were really happy.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. I was really happy.
You look stunning. Look at you, for goodness sake. Absolutely gorgeous. And it all just worked.
It did. Yeah. It went really smoothly, which is, I think that's quite rare from what I hear. Normally people have, you know, a bit of a mishap at a wedding.
Exactly.
But we were really lucky. It was great.
When did you two meet?
We actually met, Johnny's a singer-dancer, well, as you know, he auditioned for Steps as a dancer five and a half years ago, and as soon as he walked in the room, I remember saying to H, oh, he's got the job, and that was it, you know. Yeah.
So it was more or less there was an instant thing there.
Completely.
You knew.
Yeah,
you
definitely.
Knew he was definitely going to be the one.
Yeah, he was the one.
And doesn't it make it so much easier that both of you are in the same job, in a sense?
It really does.
Because you know what it's like,
both
of you. Yeah,
definitely. I mean, he's off rehearsing for Starlight Express at the minute. And
oh, has he got roller skates
on? Yeah, he's got his skates on. He's out there doing that, so good luck to him. It's really nice because there's an understanding there. And if he has to go off, you know, off on tour or, you know, I have to go away, then, you know, we understand. So,
exactly.
Yeah,
exactly. And you both, the thing about you, and you always were like this in Steps, so enthusiastic.
Yeah,
I do love it.
Yeah, I really do. That's why I'm, you know, still here doing it, because I just genuinely enjoy it.
You can tell that, though. You can tell that when you perform and everything. Now, obviously, Steps were enormous, hugely successful. And I know, as we've said, you know, it was a big shock when it all finished. You know, everybody was shocked, but actually, so were you guys. You know, it was just one of those things, and I think it came to an end before its time. I think it could have gone on. The band could have gone on, definitely.
Yeah, no, I mean, you know, the nice thing is, you know, it's all there. We've got all the you know, the videos and the memories, and yeah, it's great.
You'll have lots of stories to tell your kids when you eventually have kids.
Yeah.
You'll have a lot to tell them, that's for sure. Now, huge pressure on you when Steps. Mm-hmm. You know, finish. You have to go in with your solo career.
Yeah.
And you did well. You two top 10 singles.
Yeah, almost. The second one was 11.
11.
So yeah, almost top 10.
So that was fine.
Yeah.
And then you get dropped by the record label, which seems extraordinary.
Did. Well, I think it's their loss.
Well, but you continue because you got a new single out.
Yeah, I have. No, you know, I had a great year last year and really enjoyed doing the solo stuff. I wrote my album and, I was really pleased with it. So I've still got it there. So I've got a new single which I've written with some guys, Ben and Lee and the guys from Intensive Project.
Right.
And this is coming out next month. We're just shooting the video next week.
Excellent.
And, it's really, really different for me, actually. It's really quite cool.
Oh, good. And do you find that now there's less pressure on you, in a sense?
Well, there's no pressure now because I can't get dropped. So
no, but it seems to be it doesn't really matter how successful you are. You know, you're judged on the sales of that last single. Never mind about... Think of the millions of records that you've sold.
Yeah.
That's extraordinary.
Yeah. The nice thing is now, you know, I'm doing it for me. I'm doing it because I enjoy it. And, you know, I've got a great fan base out there. They follow me to all the gigs. So it's really good.
Oh, that's great, because that must make it even more special.
It is, you know, I do it for them, and that they keep me going.
Which is great.
Yeah.
Now, is there any difference being a married lady? Do you feel any difference?
No, it's just really lovely. I think we just feel a bit more united. And, I'm really enjoying it. Yeah,
good.
Lovely.
I'm glad to hear it. Definitely
very
glad
happy.
To hear it. Oh, there you are. God, that's some cake, girl. Isn't it? The size of you.
We've got a big family. What a big family.
Yeah, excuse me. And everybody, there's so many people that you know, obviously, that are performers. Did everybody get up and do their thing?
Well, they did, actually. We actually had our friends Liberty X. They were the entertainment.
I love Liberty X.
Yeah,
it's
funny, you know, when you've got friends in the biz, it's kind of, you know, well, why don't we have our friends sing for us rather than, you know, a band that maybe, you know, we haven't kind of seen before. We know that they're fab, and they did a great job. They got us up as well, which they were very naughty. They got us up, but yeah, it was brilliant. We had one of our friends, Tam, he sang as well,
and definitely.
Actually Andy sang in the church, which was just spectacular. Oh. It was beautiful.
He's got a great voice.
He has,
great
yeah,
voice.
Fantastic.
Really, really good. Now, we saw earlier on Jordan or Katie. I never know what to call Jordan. We'll find out tomorrow whether she's Jordan Katie and Peter Andre. Met in the jungle and did all of that. There was rumours you might be going out there. Would you ever consider doing that?
I think I would, yeah.
I think you'd be good, you know, because you'd get right stuck in.
I would get stuck
You'd clean and sort and fix and sing. Little,
I mean, you know, well, I'm from Wales, so, you know, we're always camping and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, no, I think I'd enjoy it. But, you know, we'll see. You know, if I did do it, then it's for charity. So, obviously, it would be a good thing to do.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. But you might have to eat those bugs.
I know. I don't know how I'd cope with that, really.
Oh, that's evil, evil, evil. Yeah. Listen, it's great to see you. Good luck with the single.
You.
Come back and see us when you've got the video
sorted. Get It On, by the way.
Get It On.
Yeah, thank you.
Not like you to forget.
I know.
We'll see you tomorrow. See you then. Bye-bye.